text styles enable you to quickly modify the look of a document, instead of manually having to format all the separate components. Text styles in Scribus and InDesign behave roughly in the same way. I have a text frame in Scribus and an InDesign, with two lines of text. What I want to show, is that in Scribus and an InDesign, text will always be linked to a text style. When you start a new document, you already start with a single, default paragraph style. This default style is called an InDesign basic paragraph. And in Scribus this default style is called default paragraph style. This means that when you create a text frame and you type text, the default paragraph style will determine what font you get and what size that font is. As we can see, the default paragraph style for Scribus and InDesign is Arial 12 point. So what do we do if we want to use different fonts and different sizes in our document? Let's look at this in InDesign first. When I change some text to a different font, for example to Anton, I see a plus sign appears behind basic paragraph. The plus sign means something has gone wrong with the paragraph style that is being used. The plus sign is a warning that somewhere the paragraph style has been overwritten in a way that is not recommended. To correct this, I click on the Clear Overrides button. The override will be cleared, and the plus sign disappears. Now let's do the same in Scribus. I change some text to a different font. We have now the same situation as we had in InDesign. Text has been changed incorrectly, because I didn't use a style for it. Although Scribus doesn't show a plus sign, by clicking on different parts of the text, I can see there hasn't been a different style been used to do this. There is no change in style, so we have an unrecommended style override. To correct the style override, in Scribus I select the text and click on the Remove Direct Paragraph Formatting button. The text is now correctly reconnected to the intended style. Now that we know how not to change text in Scribus and in InDesign, let's look at how we work with styles in desktop publishing software. I open the Style Manager by going to Edit, Styles. Let's also go to View, Text Frames, and choose Show Control Characters for a moment. Each time you press the Enter key, you create a new paragraph, which is visualized by the end of paragraph symbol. You can type many sentences, but as soon as you press Enter, you start a new paragraph. I will hide the control characters again. At this moment, all text is based on the default paragraph style. I click on the Character Style tab to see which font and size are used. This is Arial, and the size is 12 point. To show that the text is linked to this style, let's choose another font, for example Anton. To see the change in my document I click on Apply. All text has now changed to Anton. I set it back to Arial. Now let's say I want to have my head to be Anton. I will create a new paragraph style for it. I click on New, and choose Paragraph Style. I name the style Head. I choose Anton. I click on Apply. At the left we now see a paragraph style called Head, is added below default paragraph style. To apply the new style to my text, I first click inside the paragraph that I want to adjust. Then in the text properties, I click on default paragraph style. From the list, I choose Head. The Head paragraph style is now applied to the text. Now let's say I want the head text to be larger. In the Style Manager I increase the size of the text. I click on Apply. And let's say I want a bit more space between the head and the body copy text. I click on the Properties tab. In the Space Below Entry field, I increase the distance with 5 point. As said in the beginning of this video, text styles enable you to quickly modify the look of a document, instead of manually having to format all the separate components. If you have many pages, and you need to change something, you will have to do this only once. Let's say the head needs to be bigger. I increase the size, and click on Apply. Now on all pages in my document where there are heads, they are all updated. In this lecture, we looked at paragraph styles. In the next lecture, we will look at character styles.